thanks for staying with us on Headlines Now on NDTV Hindu. Now to get you some other news from the city. It's the festive season and kicking off some bling buys is the annual Zac Expo, which has the city's shopaholics looking for a one-of-a-kind gold design. Now from antique collections to the contemporary lace designs, it's all here under one roof. Well, if you're not a self-confessed gold shopaholic, then this will sure get you to become one.
This exhibition is the 101st edition and we have 20 jewelers from all over India. They have brought in about over 20,000 designs, and being a festival season, they have brought the latest designs which are on display and also on sale. We, in the next 4 days, 3 days, we are expecting a good sale, and I think the best varieties of diamonds with the latest designs are brought in by organizers and participants from Bombay, Delhi, Jaipur, Bangalore, Chennai.
Well, definitely that would be the one-stop shop for all the wedding jewelry shopping or even the festive shopping. But well, moving on to some other news from the country. News from Mamata Banerjee's Bengal state. The Dunlop factory at Shaganj area near Hooghly has formally shut down today after a notice of suspension of work was put up at the factory. Now, there had been no production in the factory for some years now, even though the workers were still reporting to work. Now, this means that hundreds of workers will no longer get paid. Well, on to some international news now. A traffic accident involving a bus and a car killed 35 people and injured 19 others in China's port city of Tianjin. The bus flipped over after crashing into the rear end of a car. Now, most of the people on board were college students who were on their way back to school after the national holidays. Well, on to some sports news now. It was the first ever visit by an English Premier team to India as the Blackburn Rovers took on Pune FC. Now, the Indian-owned EPL club was expected to rout Pune's FC, but thanks to some good goalkeeping by the Pune goalie, the match ended with a more respectable 3-0 win for the Blackburns.
The atmosphere at the Balewadi Stadium in Pune was electric as the Blackburn Rovers took on Pune FC. With the might of factor Sunil Shetty behind them, the Rovers, owned by Venky's Chicken, get an advantage right away as Pune were reduced to just 10 men. And it wasn't long before Blackburn took advantage of that, Jason Roberts breaking the deadlock. In the pouring rain, the Rovers continued to delight the Indian owners, scoring the second of the night through Ruben Rokina. Goal scoring might have been even more frenetic had the Pune goalkeeper Shanilal Meloli not pulled off some fantastic saves. The final nail in the coffin came at the hand of Roberts, the Rovers winning their first ever match on Indian soil 3-0.
Now this could be an opportunity and a third. It's a second on the night for Jason Roberts.
Well, that was a good show by the Blackburns, you'd say. But on to some cricket news now. Now, everybody is definitely sitting at their television screens, if not at the stadium, trying to wait up for that big semi-final match of the Champions League tonight. Now, a spirited Mumbai Indians, who won the toss early in the evening and have opted to bat, will bank on their familiarity with the conditions to fight through another tough challenge when they take on England Somerset in the semi-finals of the Champions League 2020 at the M.A. Chidambaram Stadium tonight. Now, despite being an injury-ravaged side, the chances of the Mumbai Indians without 8 key players such as skipper Sachin Tendulkar, the pacer Zahir Khan, Munaf Patel and batsman Rohit Sharma are brighter than Somerset, who reached the Champions League group through qualification. Now remember, both these teams were written off before the tournament, but both have defied skeptics to gatecrash their way into the semi-finals. Well, we'll get you all those updates later on in the bulletins. But that's all the time we have on this bulletin. Keep watching NDTV Hindu. Thanks for watching.